So far in this course, we have seen four mathematical representations for languages, and they are DFA, NFA, NFA with epsilon transitions, and regular grammar. And we have proved that each one of them represents the family of regular languages. And today, we are going to discuss a new mathematical representation for languages, namely regular expression. What is a regular expression? These are expressions built from the alphabets or these two special symbols using the operators plus, dot and star. We can see their semantics later. And a regular expression represents a language or strings over an alphabet. So each regular expression is going to represent a language. Look at the basic set of regular expressions. Phi is a regular expression by definition, representing the language empty set. If you remember, every subset of sigma star is a language, so null set is again a language, which is represented by phi. It's a meaningful notation for that regular expression. The second basic regular expression is empty string. Epsilon is a regular expression representing the language. The language of epsilon, the regular expression epsilon, is set epsilon. These two are different languages. Here, empty language. Here, a language with one string, which is the empty string. And for every alphabet A, the alphabet itself is a regular expression representing the language. The language of A is set A. Another example, the language of B is set B. So these are the basic set of regular expressions. Phi representing null set, epsilon representing set epsilon, and for any alphabet A, the regular expression A represents the language set A. And now we have to introduce these operators, and for that we need to have some notations and definitions. For all languages over an alphabet set sigma, L raised to 0 by definition is the set epsilon. That's a language which contains only empty string. This is for all languages, regardless of what the language L is. L raised to 0 is set epsilon. Please try to remember what is L raised to 0. Regardless of L, it is set epsilon. And L raised to 1 is L itself. And L raised to 2 is L raised to 1 concatenated with L. L raised to 1 is L. That is, L raised to 2 means L concatenated with L 2 times. L raised to 3 can be recursively defined as L raised to 2 concatenated with L. Or L raised to 3 is L concatenated with L 3 times. And now we can generalize and say L raised to I plus 1 is L raised to I concatenated with L. Let us see an example. Let L be this language. And what is L raised to 0? By definition, L raised to 0. Regardless of L, L raised to 0 is set epsilon. And L raised to 1, by definition, it's the language itself. And what is L raised to 2? It is L raised to 1 concatenated with L. So the concatenation of this with itself is this language. And L raised to 3 is L raised to 2 concatenated with L raised to 1 by definition. This is the definition, and hence this is the language. This concatenated with A gives you the first four strings, and this concatenated with B gives you the second four strings. And now we can define the Kleene iteration of a language, L star. And this is known as the Kleene iteration of a language L, or also known as the star closure of a language L. So let me use these two terms, either the star closure of L or Kleene iteration of L. which is defined as this. This is a definition. L raised to 0, union L raised to 1, union L raised to 2, etc. Union of all these languages, infinite union. Later we can see an example. And now these notations can be used to define new regular expressions. If you recall, the basic set of regular expressions that we discussed are phi representing the null set, epsilon representing set epsilon, and for any alphabet A, A itself is a regular expression representing the language set A. These are the basic set. Now we are going to see rules for defining new regular expression from the basic set of regular expressions. Suppose R1 and R2 are regular expression, then using plus you can generate R1 plus R2 as a regular expression, and its semantics or language is, the language of R1 plus R2 is language of R1 union language of R2. So plus represents set union. L of R1 is a language union L of R2. Using concatenation from R1 and R2, you will get this regular expression. If R1 and R2 are regular expressions, then R1 dot R2 is a regular expression representing the language of R1 concatenated with language of R2. Fairly easy. Now, R1 star is a regular expression. These are the three operators, plus, dot, and star. R1 star is a regular expression representing the language of R1 whole star, that is the star cluster of language of R1. So these are the three rules which can be used to define regular expression. Later we can formally see it again. Now proceed and see examples of regular expressions and their languages. Let R1 is A and R2 is B. R3 is formed by plus. The question is, what is L of R3, which is L of A plus B? From the previous slide, we know that L of A plus B is L of A union L of B. And L of A, from the basic set of regular expression, L of A is set A, L of B is set B. Set A union set B, which is equal to set AB. Another example, R1 is A, R2 is B, R3 is formed by concatenation. So what is L of R3, which is L of A concatenated with B? From the previous slide, we know that it is L of A concatenated with L of B. From the basic definition, we know L of A is set A, L of B is set B, and this concatenation is giving you set AB. Please try to remember, A plus B represents this language, set A or B, and AB represents the language, set AB. And this dot is optional. You don't have to explicitly show this in the regular expression. You can also say AB. And the third example, let R1 is A plus B, R2 is C, and R3 is formed by R1 concatenated with R2. That is A plus B concatenated with C. So what is L of R3? Which is L of A plus B concatenated with C. Now from the previous slide, we know it is L of A plus B concatenated with L of C. And from this, we know that L of A plus B is set AB. So set AB concatenated with set C, which is AC and BC. Just the application of concatenation. So these are simple languages. So maybe you can see it again if you want, and let us see more examples. Now suppose R is a regular expression which is just A, then what is L of R star? From the definition we know that it is L of A the whole star, that is set A star. That is set A raised to 0, set A raised to 1, etc. If you remember, set A raised to 0 is epsilon. For any set, raised to 0 is epsilon. So I should put a bracket here, curly braces, sorry for that. So this is the language. This is A raised to 0, A raised to 1, A raised to 2, etc. So this is it. I am just concatenating. It goes like this, and you can generalize this that set of all a raised to I says that I is greater than or equal to 0, not that a raised to 0 is epsilon. To see R star again, let us consider R as a plus b, and you see what is L of R star, which is L of a plus b the whole star. And we know that L of A plus B is set AB. So it's a set AB the whole star. That is set AB raised to 0, which is epsilon. Set AB raised to 1, set AB raised to 2, likewise it goes. So here I applied concatenation to get this. And if you observe, you can see that it is actually the set of all strings over AB. This is a very important information. The regular expression A plus B the whole star, that's what R star is, A plus B the whole star, represents all strings over AB. Please try to remember this, A plus B the whole star. You can see the semantics through this derivation, but try to remember that A plus B the whole star represents all strings over AB. With that, let us see more examples. So here is a regular expression given. Can you guess the language? This is A star plus B star concatenated with C. You know that A star will give you A raised to I, where I is greater than or equal to 0. Similarly B star. So the language is A raised to I, where I is greater than or equal to 0, concatenated with C. A raised to I concatenated with C, or A raised to B raised to I concatenated with C. So this is the language. If you recall the definition of A star and B star, you will get it. Another example. So what is this language? Can you guess? You know that A plus B the whole star here and here represent any string over AB. And there must be ABB. And the language is all strings with ABB as a substring. And if the string is X is starting with the ABB, you can generate epsilon from here. So it can start with ABB. If it is ending with ABB, you can generate epsilon from here. And if it is not starting or ending, you can generate the LHS string with this regular expression and the RHS string with this regular expression. It's not difficult to see. Try to understand what is it represent. Third example, this is a little more complex. So it's A plus B star, that is any string, followed by a B, followed by A plus B, followed by A plus B. Or in other words, the last symbol can be either A or B. The second last symbol can be either A or B. But the third last symbol is fixed as B, and that is the language. The set of all strings with the third last symbol as a B. And the last example here, which is a complex one to interpret. Can you guess what the language is? If you look at this bracket, so star means any repetition of this. There are two A's. 0 or more repetition, so you will get 2A's, 4A's, 0A's, 2A's, 4A's, etc. And before and after an A, you can have B's, 0 or more B's. And the language is the set of all strings with even number of A's. But it is not very easy to see, but at the end of this lecture, I'm giving you an exercise to see why it is. So till that, just take it as granted, this is the language. And every other language is very intuitive to understand. And now, this is a reverse question. Given a language, how can you come up with a regular expression? The language is that of all binary strings, set that every 4-bit block is having even number of A's. Sorry, even number of 1's. It should be 1. That's a typo. Even number of 1's. Sorry for that. Example, here is a binary string. If you divide it into 4-bit blocks, this is the first block, second block, third block, etc. First block 2, once, second block again 2 once, third block 2 once, fourth again 2 once. So every time even number of ones. And the last block is not containing 4 elements, so you don't have to worry about the number of ones here. So after the last block, there could be 0, 1, 2 or 3 more simples that you can leave. The question is, can you come up with a regular expression for generating all binary strings such that every block of length 4 like this contains even number of ones, it should be ones. Can you construct? So you can see that this is actually every block is a 4-bit binary string with even number of ones. So you can write it as all 4-bit binary strings with even number of ones. There are 8 such 4-bit binary strings. Summation of that star, that means any combination of these strings followed by a string of at most length 3. It could be epsilon, strings of length 1, length 2, etc., length 3. That's it. So this is a regular expression. If you are not able to understand it now, please watch it again, think about it and see what is it representing. Now we can formalize the definition of regular expressions. So it can be defined inductively or recursively. So what is the basis? These are the basic set of regular expressions, that is phi and A are regular expressions. Note that A is an alphabet. So if the alphabet set sigma is containing 10 alphabets, then there are 11 basic regular expressions. Each alphabet is a regular expression and phi is a regular expression. Now the inductive step. If R1 and R2 are regular expressions, then R1 plus R2 is a regular expression, R1 R2 is a regular expression, R1 star is a regular expression. So these are the rules. Okay, this is how you define regular expressions inductively. There are two basic regular expressions. This is representing an alphabet. So as many as there are alphabets in sigma. And these are the rules. Now the meaning or semantics or language represented. Language represented by the regular expression phi is null set, you know. A is set A for any alphabet. R1 plus R2 is a regular expression and the language is language of R1 union language of R2. R1 R2 is representing this language. Language of R1 concatenated with language of R2. R1 star or R star is a regular expression representing the language of R, the whole star. And now if you recall, when we started with the regular expression, we have discussed one more basic regular expression, which was epsilon. Now the question is, why is it that you don't need it in the formal definition? Because you can define epsilon as phi star. Epsilon is nothing but phi star, because phi represents null set and null set star is null set raised to 0, which is set epsilon, null set raised to 1, etc., etc., are all null sets. So you just try what it is and you can define it like this. And now we can proceed and see the semantics of a regular expression by using an expression tree. Expression tree for representing the meaning of a regular expression or the semantics of a regular expression. So here is a regular expression, A star plus B star concatenated with C. So this is the expression tree. And this is representing A star. And this is representing B star. And this subtree is representing A star plus B star. And the whole tree is representing A star plus B star concatenated with C. It's not difficult to see. And the leaf nodes are going to be alphabets or say null set or phi. Now how you can associate the semantics? Just say small a is representing this language, small b is representing this language, small c is a regular expression representing this language. So semantics is strong. And now we can work upwards. If this is the case, then what is A star representing star cluster of this language, which is this. And star cluster of this language is this. Now this plus represents union of these two. Just take the union of these two sets. So you will get this set. So this is just the union of these two sets arranged in the order of length. And now what? Concatenate this language with C. With C, you will get C, then AC, BC, etc. That's what it is. So if you draw the expression tree, then you can find the language represented. Systematically, you can find it. So here is the last slide of the lecture. I am giving you two assignment questions. First one is, you write regular expressions for these languages. Not difficult. You try to see how can you write regular expressions. And second is, draw expression trees to show the semantics of these regular expressions R0 and R1. And with this, we are finishing this lecture, and in the next class, we can see the class of languages represented by regular expressions. Thank you.